The bar shown in the figure is made of a single piece of material. It is fixed at one end. It consists of two segments of equal length L by 2, but different cross-sectional areas A and 2A. What is the change in the length of the entire system under the action of an axial force F? So there will be an axial force F in this direction. So it is asked that what is the extension of the entire system? Consider the shape of the joint to remain circular, given y equal to Young's modulus. Anyway, so the material is same for both the rods. So if you pull this rod from one end, of course the first rod pulls the thicker rod, and that thicker rod pulls the wall, and in fact according to the Newton's third law, the wall also pulls it back. So in fact you have two segments. One is this thicker segment, another is this thinner segment. I'm trying to draw the free body diagram type of force diagram. So you are pulling this in this direction. This pulls the thicker one in this direction, and the thicker one also pulls it back in this way. And the thicker one pulls the wall, as well as the wall pulls this thicker one back. So ultimately both are experiencing balanced force, is it not? So we can say that both experiences balanced force. And what does this balanced force results in? The balanced force creates extension. So therefore both would undergo elastic extension. Now you are able to understand that the force is same. So of course the stress will be different as the cross-sectional areas are different. So that force divided by A, I'm talking about the thinner one, force divided by A, what it will be? It will be the stress, is it not? And now the stress, what do you mean by stress? Stress is the restoring force per unit area. Now the same restoring force is same as that of the tension that you have created. So force by area is stress. This stress will be equal to y into, that is Young's modulus, multiplied by the strain, that is change in length of the first one, divided by the original length. So let it be the first one for the thin rod. Similarly, we will be writing for the thick rod. What we can do is force divided by the cross-sectional area, which is 2A, is the stress, and that stress will be equal to y into strain. Now what is strain? Strain will be the change in length for the second divided by the original length. So this is the second for the thick rod. So from these two, we find out what is the independently the extension of the first and the extension of the second. So the extension of the first, we got it, and once we get it, let me write it, is it not? So it will be equal to F divided by AY, and the 2 comes down. And here what we can write, we will be writing F divided by A, that 2 goes down, so this becomes 4, and Y comes down, so this will be F by 4AY. So now the total extension of the composite system of rods, we can write as delta L as delta L1 plus delta L2. Now see delta L1, what we have written, if I think there will be one L here, capital L, and delta 2 here also capital L, it will be there. So delta L total for the composite rod, it should be equal to FL divided by 2AY plus FL divided by 4AY. Now this 1 by 2 plus 1 by 4, it comes out to be 3 by 4. And this is FL divided by AY. So I hope you understand this. The total extension of the composite rod is 3FL by 4AY. Thank you.